questions 510, find the inorder successor in a binary search tree. Yeah, so let's use the example 2. We have a tree with a structure like this. And let's say the given nodes here is tree here. And we don't want to look for the successor. So as we can see, this is the successor of node 3 is node number 4, which is what is right children. So in this case, we are going to look for the right children. But what if there is another node here, such as, another 3.5? Yeah, let's assume that there's node 3.5. So 3.5 will be the next successor because 3.5 is less than 4 in this case. What if there's another node here, 3.4? In this case, 3.4 will be the next successor. So basically it means if there is a node, there's a right children, then look for the leftmost children. Leftmost children in right branch. So what if there's no children for node 3? Then look for the parent. Else look for the parents. Which parents? The first parent on the right. Yeah. So let's say our parents of this tree is here. Is this the first parent on the right? No, it is not. This is the first parent on the right. So we will look for the first parent of the right or on the right. Yeah, in this case it's 4. So pretty straightforward. Let's start coding. If there is a right child, look for the less more children in the child in the right branch. Else, look for the first parent on the right. So if look to right, then there's a right children. So let's say child equal to note dot right. Say well, child has a right children or has a left children. Then we update the child. Child equal to child dot left. If child doesn't have a left children, then we will simply return child in this case. Yeah, so child is the less more children, less more child in the right branch. So else we look for the parents. So let's say parents is equal to note dot parents and while the parent is valid, check if the parent is on the right. How to check it? Simple. Simply say, simply check if the parent, if the left child of the parents is equal to our current nodes. If yes, then simply return the parent. Else, we will update both the parent and the nodes. So we say nodes is equal to the parents, and the parent is equal to the parent of the parent. So we go one level above. Yeah, so if we reach the end case, if we reach this stage, it means that the parents, it means that there's no parent on the right. What does it mean? It means we come to a situation where what should I do? Yeah, it means we end up in a situation such that our tree looks like this. So tree itself is already the largest number in this tree, and there's no successor. So we will simply return now in this case. So return now. Yeah, let's run this code. Let's use a more complicated test case. We try submit. Yeah, we got this. So let's do a time analysis. We simply iterating through the leftmost children. The leftmost children, or on the right side, or all the parents, which means we will iterate at most n nodes in this case. So the time complexity is simply O n. So time O n, where n stands for number of nodes. Where n is the number of nodes. What's the space complexity? We can see that our stack tree has a there's no stack tree in this case, so the space complexity is simply O1. But if you are using DFS or a recursion to do this, then the space will be maybe equal to O n, while n is the height of the tree. Yeah, so simple as that. For the source code, simply look at the link follow below, and for solutions of other LeetCode questions in JavaScript, also can refer to the GitHub repo below. See you.